Welcome to this video tutorial on the anatomy and blood flow of the heart. The heart is one of the most amazing organs of the body. Understanding and remembering the anatomy of the heart and how the blood flows through it can be a daunting task, but hopefully this video will help simplify the process and you will do well on your exam questions over the heart. The heart is a four-chambered muscle weighing between 7 to 15 ounces and is a little larger than the size of your fist. The average heart beats 100,000 times per day, pumping about 2,000 gallons of blood. The heart is surrounded by a double-layered membrane called the pericardium. The inner layer, or visceral pericardium, and the outer layer, the parietal pericardium, contain a clear pericardial fluid between them that reduces the friction produced by the pumping action of the heart. The heart is divided in half by a muscular wall, the septum. Each half has an upper collecting chamber, the atrium, and a lower pumping chamber, the ventricle. The left ventricle has the thickest muscular wall, having enough force to push blood through the aortic valve and into the body. You can remember their location because A comes before V. The atrium is above the ventricle. The heart has four valves that control the flow of blood from the atria into the ventricles and from the ventricles into the two large arteries connected to the heart. On the right side of the heart, we have the tricuspid valve. It is between the right atrium and the right ventricle and has three cusps. There is also the pulmonary valve, between the right ventricle and the entrance to the pulmonary artery. On the left side of the heart, we have the bicuspid or mitral valve, which is between the left atrium and left ventricle and has two cusps. We also have the aortic valve, between the left ventricle and the entrance to the aorta. The valves are like doors that open and close, preventing blood from flowing backwards. It is the lub-dub sound heard with a stethoscope. The heart takes in oxygen-poor blood from the body, shown in blue, and delivers it to the lungs, where it gets oxygenated. The red portion shows oxygen-rich blood traveling from the lungs through the heart to the rest of the body. Remember, veins bring blood towards the heart. Arteries carry blood away from the heart. You can remember the A for arteries and away. Now we will follow the circulation of blood flow through the heart step by step. First, we'll look at the flow of blood through the right side of the heart. Blood enters the heart from the upper and lower body by way of the superior and inferior vena cava. Blood flows from the right atrium, mainly by gravity, through the tricuspid valve and into the right ventricle. Blood is pumped from the right ventricle, through the pulmonary valve, into the pulmonary artery, and on to the lungs to be oxygenated. On the left side of the heart, the oxygenated blood returns to the heart by way of the pulmonary vein. Blood enters the left atrium, flows through the bicuspid or mitral valve, and into the left ventricle. When the left ventricle contracts, blood goes through the aortic valve, into the aorta, and on to the rest of the body. The flow of blood through the atria and ventricles is actually happening simultaneously. Each heartbeat is a two-part pumping action that occurs in about 1 second. You can see as the blood flows from the atria to the ventricles, it goes through the tricuspid and bicuspid valves, also known as the atrioventricular valves. These valves then snap shut, making the first heart sound, S1, or lub in lub-dub. As these two valves snap shut, the pulmonary and aortic valves just opened. The ventricles contract, pumping blood through the pulmonary valve leading to the lungs, and the aortic valve leading to the aorta and the rest of the body. These valves then snap shut, making the second heart sound, S2, or dub in lub-dub. At the same time, the tricuspid and bicuspid valves just opened, and the process repeats. To remember the order that blood flows through the heart valves, tricuspid, pulmonary, bicuspid, and aortic. Remember, try performing better always. The four chambers of the heart are continually contracting and relaxing in a pattern known as the cardiac cycle. As blood collects in the atria contract, pushing the blood through the tricuspid and bicuspid valves into the ventricles. The ventricles are filling, and this phase is called diastole. When the ventricles are full of blood, they contract to pump blood throughout the body, known as the contracting or pumping phase, which is called systole. The heart normally beats about 60 to 80 times per minute when at rest, but this can vary. The heart is a muscle designed to remain strong and reliable for many years. I covered a lot of information here, so be sure and review the pictures and diagrams. And thank you for watching this video tutorial on the blood flow and anatomy of the heart. Be sure to subscribe and check out our other videos.